my talk is a bit out of the thread here. So no energy, no solar, no wind, nothing of this kind, yeah? And from the other point, also no diffusion, no Makin-Vlasov, though I personally like Makin-Vlasov and diffusion. But this time I will speak about a completely different thing, namely about the models with finite state space. And since, and also motivated not by energy, but some social kind of interactions like corruption, inspection, cybersecurity, terrorism, and so on. So before showing you the slides, I just give you a couple of minutes of general picture, what it's all about, and what is actually the main point which I'd like to stress here, and what are the main view of the models. So as I say, the point is that we have finite states model, and as you can imagine, the more states there are, the more difficult becomes the analysis. So the simple one, which where I started was this model simplest of corruption, when you have corrupted agent, honest agent, and reserved agent, yeah? So the three things, yeah? And with these three things, you can basically solve everything, well, up to explicit numbers, yeah? Well, everything, I mean stationary solution. In fact, and as you see, main big part of my talk is about stationary solution on finite state space. You can basically solve them numerically because this is some kind of algebraic now relation, this mean field game consistency equation. So, by the way, I also mentioned the people who motivated me. So this corruption, I have a colleague from St. Petersburg who is permanently talking with me about corruption. So we even think about writing some small monograph about it, and he suggested the title Corruption for Everybody. Well, because we previously had a book called Game Theory for Everybody. So, well, now Corruption for Everybody. Well, I think this possibly not the most appropriate one. Okay, and the second motivation, which came from Alan Ben-Susan, is about botnet defense. And here, very natural to consider three-state model. So we have a computer infected or susceptible. Susceptible means they are not yet affected, yeah? And then we have a computer which are defended by some system and not defended by some system. So you have these four kind of points, defended, infected, non-defended, susceptible, and so on. So this is botnet defense, and this is also epidemiology. And in fact, Alan Ben-Susan started with a very nice sort of game theoretic model, not mean field. And in the discussion with him, we developed here this mean field version. And finally, to go further, you can increase this thing. So the next step, which I'm going to speak about, if we have this somehow 2 by D, yeah? So this can be, again, infected or not infected, infected, susceptible. In the formulation of the corruption, it can be corrupted or honest, and here they are somehow the levels of usually I think this hierarchical level. So if about corruption, this is the level of a bureaucrat on a staircase, yeah. And if I'm talking about botnet defense, these are the level of the defense of your computer, or this could be just different providers, yeah. When we're talking about some illegal sort of drug traffic, yeah, this could be different passes through the mountains of Afghanistan, for example, yeah? Something like that, yeah. So if we're talking about terrorism, yeah, so this is again involvement in different terroristic group on different possibly geographically distributed, yeah. So this is 2 by D. And I will possibly present the main result to the setting. And in further, we have, in fact, here the square. So this will be then the level of involvement in sort of terrorist activity, in corruption, in inspection, and so on. Yeah.
Graduate.
Yes. Yeah, so there is natural here two level of differentiation. Yeah. One is kind of hierarchy or geography, and another, your level of involvement in, well, it, there is no moral estimate here, yeah? If in terrorism, okay, there is bad activity, yeah? When if we're talking about the botnet defenses, vice versa, this is the bad guy is the upper guy, yeah? And you are choosing your innocent measures of defense here, yeah? Instead of choosing the level of your terrorist attack, okay? So that's the group of things. So it's corruption. Also, corruption is very much linked with inspection. In fact, I started with inspection. So again, this is the way to avoid tax payment, yeah? So then the inspector is a good guy, well, good for somebody, good or bad, who try to find out whether you pay taxes or not. Then comes corruption, which is vice versa. Now we have inspectors which are corrupted, and there is some benevolent dictator, as is usually the word in the literature. And so then botnet defense and terrorism, and then further on there goes in principle minefield game on networks in various versions. Okay, but this is all this social kind of flavor. So now general modeling is what I call somehow many years ago when I started thinking about nonlinear Markov games. It is setting somehow combined mean field game version with everyone thinking rationally, with mean field type, Ben Susan kind of type thing, yeah, when we have a controller which controls the distribution of the whole population. So there is really the mixture here, yeah, pairwise interaction, rational behavior, and above control of the whole distribution. So this really these three levels of modeling here, yeah? So they are developing. So this is a modeling setting. Now about mathematics, what I'd like to present. So this is modeling, now about mathematics. About mathematics, effectively, I'd like to put forward two basic ideas. So first of all, when we write model for three, for stationary, we basically can solve. I will show you we can solve explicitly. Yeah, the more you add additional nodes, yeah, the analysis even for stationary problem, yeah, I'm first talking about stationary, becomes more and more complicated. So what can we do? And the idea is somehow it goes back to the famous Russian physicist. I like to quote him, Nikolai Bogolyubov, who used to say, my whole life I searched for a small parameter. So this is precisely the thing, the point here, yeah? We are looking for different asymptotic regimes. And the more complicated becomes our model, yeah, we introduce more asymptotic regimes, so some parameter to zero to infinity, yeah? And you can see that this is more realistic or less realistic, but anyway, this asymptotic regime gives you somehow the core around which, with the perturbation technique, you can reconstruct even the whole scenery. Yeah? So we'll see, and there are three basic these asymptotic regimes. Yeah, so asymptotics. Yeah. So first of all, fast execution. By fast execution, I mean fast execution of your personal decision. If I'd like to switch from paying taxes to non-paying taxes, okay, I've decided I'm doing now, yeah? So of course the model is as a Markov chain, there is exponential waiting time, but this time of waiting basically to infinity, yeah, to zero, yeah? We decide, we do. So this is fast execution. Second thing is small discounting. Yeah, when we have this delta parameter, you know, in a discounting version of Hamilton-Jacobi equation, if this delta goes to zero, this creates very natural simplification in the model. And final is a weak interaction, of course. So, of course, these are reasonably sort of justifiable, yeah? And this is somehow technical necessity. Yeah, interaction may be weak or not, so this is technical necessity, yeah? So once I move from here to here to here, I'm taking more and more and more of these asymptotic tools to deal with the problem, okay? So this is the first idea, mathematical, how to deal with stationary problem. And second idea is how to deal with time-dependent problems. And here the idea, here comes this turnpike, yeah? So this is the title of my... So most of you, I suppose, has an idea about what is turnpike. This is a long story invented by economists, and the famous John von Neumann contributed here quite a lot. He is one of the, founder, but I do not remember. It was not him who started the thing, yeah?
And
Earlier than Samuelson, I suppose. But Samuelson, yes, also in the game. But I suppose it's somewhere 30s of the last century. Yeah. So the idea is that there is, so let me say, because I think this is important kind of idea. So we are looking, we are planning, have long horizon. And at the end of this long planning, yeah, we are military, yeah, would like to produce more tanks, yeah, at the end, yeah. And otherwise, we are not military, we are very nice people, we want to produce more food, we like more butter after 10 or 15 years, you see? So the idea of this turnpike theory is that there is some stationary kind of natural, harmonical kind of way of doing economy, yeah? And you, from where you are, you have go to this stationary development, yeah? Move along the stationary development independently of whether you want tanks or better. And at the end, just last moment, you switch all your power either to these tanks or to the better. Yeah? So these turnpikes, yeah, is this road. And the word turnpikes, of course, come from, you know, if you want to go from Alan Turing to the institute where will be next conference in Edinburgh, yeah? Of course, you not go directly, yeah? You have the small streets to the motorway, and again, small streets, to the institute. You see, this is turnpike, which you have to follow. And here, the same idea. So turnpikes, which were developed for economics model, it's for Neyman Gale, and for also for stochastic games. For example, I had result here on stochastic games, turnpike. And here, it turns out that for mean field games, the same story works. So we really can make stationary solution. And this stationary solution provides you this turnpike, yeah, for the large class of time-dependent mean field game solution. Okay, so this is the second mathematical point in this talk. And I just repeat that, so there are some people working with me, and as I say, this professor from Petersburg, Alan Ben-Susan, and finally I had my PhD students, and Dario here was an external examiner. So these are people, this is Stamatis Katsikas, just completed, so these three people contributed to this work. Okay, so I explain you the main thing, yeah? So now will be a bit more detail, a bit more formulas, you see, so will be not so nice, but that was somehow the main point to pass you, okay? Okay, so again, some general overview. And there is really, I repeat, this is some unification of research, yeah? Because in fact, there is also another point which would be possibly nice to mention here, yeah? You see, I'm saying everything, and corruption, and inspection, and counter-terrorism. Remarkably, there are journals devoted to terrorism. There are groups of people doing corruption. If you look at their models, they are identical. But these people have no idea that they're doing precisely the same thing, yeah? So I looked at the group of papers on counter-terrorism, group of papers on corruption, group of papers on inspection. Mathematics, identical. Moreover, since these people are not usually people dealing with this, they are not really often mathematicians, yeah? So they are usually playing with two players game. And for example, the people on counter-terrorism, there are several big papers, and they're saying, well, unfortunately, there are more terrorists than just two, but because we do not know how to model four people, four player games, so we are just saying about, and it would be nice to develop it for, you know, finite number or big number of terrorists. And that's what I'm doing. Arbitrary number of terrorists. You like 100, you like 1,000, it would be 1,000. Okay, and of course we take the limit, yeah, we take the limit number to infinity. But do not worry, there was some here people talking, well, billion, million. No billion, no million. Note that the error is 1 over n. So if I have 10 players, 10 terrorists, yeah, instead of infinity, yeah, my mistake will be about 10%. Okay, now, of course, the point for the application is here important, because there are lots of small parameters which you really don't know where to take from. Therefore, to make this whole thing working, yeah, there's quite a lot fields sort of investigation about several key parameters in the model. And that's what should be done in order to make this all really seriously working. Okay, but that's the point. Large number of players, as I said, nonlinear Markov control, which include mean field, MFG, evolutionary. And all under the setting of discrete space. And as I mentioned, the first model, three-state model, then four-state model. Also a point which worth mentioning, and I did not mention, and this is very important word here, I think, phase transition, which we can see already on this three model. Also, you know, there's very important question in mean field game, and we keep saying about it. Well, we'd like to have unique, but usually it's not unique. Now, here you can really see how many there are. So here in this model, we'll get three solutions. And there is nice bifurcation, precisely like van der Waals gas. It just jumps under the same pleat. You can just see it, how it jumps from one to this three solution, yeah? Under the same thing, yeah? So this phase transition we can really observe for three-state model and even more complicated four-state model, which we will speak about this botnet defense. You also can see this phase transition more or less explicitly. Okay, and then finally this turnpike story. Okay, so now in more detail about this modeling, so starting with the simple one, yeah? As I mentioned, one of the three states, honest, corrupted, reserved. By the way, let me comment about this word reserved. This is standard in the corruption literature models, assuming that that if a corrupted agent is somehow his misbehavior is discovered, then he is sent to this reserved job, yeah, where he gets very, very low salary and already has no possibility to do his bad corruption activity. Yeah? So these three kind of states, they are taken from the really quite extensive literature, classical more or less already literature, from corruption games. Okay, then we have some budget B of the principle. And here you see also the link with game theory with major player. Yeah? There is some major player, some principle behind. Yeah, of course, should be here. Yeah, the one who invests in finding out this corrupted, the corrupted behavior of the agent. Yeah, and on the level of botnet defense, yeah, this will be botnet herder, yeah, who tries to, you know, infect your computers with various kind of bad viruses, yeah? Okay, so now how we're modeling, of course, you can imagine what are the state space, the number of honest, the number of corrupted, the number of reserved. So these three numbers, NH, NC, and R, describes you the state space, yeah? So I'm saying three state, of course, yeah? But effectively, it is, of course, infinitely many automatically, yeah? And again, there was discussion about it, and I suppose Alan also made this comment. Okay, you have three numbers, yeah? Three or four states, but if you put many on each of them, yeah? Then directly you get this infinitely many, yeah? So the same here. These are supposed to be, in fact, large in some sense, yeah? But these are three numbers which defines you everything. And of course, it's very natural to speak about fractions, yeah? So really, state space will be this n divided by the total number of agents, yeah? So these some fractions or probabilities which sums up to one. Okay, now control parameters. I assume here just very simple. You see, I'm trying to make something as simple as possible that you could really do things with it. So control parameters, we usually, again, assume some u in some interval, yeah? Here, I'm assuming no interval, just 0 or 1. Either I'm happy with my state or I'd like to change it. If I'd like to change it, I press the button and some exponential waiting time, I'm switching, yeah? So I want to be corrupted, okay, I start taking bribes. Yeah? I do not want, I stop it. Yeah? There could be some memory effect, of course, yeah? But this is somehow the simplest thing. Okay, so that is our control parameter, and then we are saying that this occurs with some rates lambda, as and I mentioned eventually I would like to send this lambda to infinity, fast execution. So this is first parameter in this asymptotic setting, fast execution. Lambda will be sent to infinity. And we have this recovery rate, yeah, from R to H. So if you are sitting long on your recovery, then at some point, you know, we need new bureaucrats. So at some point, you will be possibly promoted back to the position which you had previously, yeah? And the same, okay, I always advise thinking really in two settings, this corruption and botnet defense, yeah? Reserved is kind of, you know, you're out, your computer is not working, yeah? But at some point, you know, you invest some money and will be either cleaned or you just buy a new one, okay? And then you're back to the game. Okay, so now I introduce this, what I stress is the evolutionary component of the interaction, which is binary interaction, which is something which is not really well developed kind of in the mean field game setting, yeah? We really can see the pairs, yeah? Which can influence each other. So I can make decision to become corrupted, but I can be just influenced, yeah? This is kind of social norms. I am talking with the Alex, Vassily, you can get a great money if you just avoid paying taxes. Why are you not doing it? I said, yes, great, of course, yeah. and this, so we assume here sort of this interaction, which has two parameters, yeah? Social and infection. Infection is kind of propagation of these bad habits, yeah, pairwise. And social is vice versa, yeah? So we can assume that there is sort of people, there is almost no corruption, yeah? The atmosphere is to be honest, yeah? And therefore, if some guys appear, then his peers, which are honest, yeah, can help, in fact, this benevolent dictator, yeah, to find these bad guys, yeah, and punish them and put them to their reserve state, yeah? So there are two types of this binary interaction. Binary interaction which propagates this bad behavior, binary interaction which helps to punish sort of the trespassers, okay? And that's now the first equation that we get. Now the equation I have written is the equation in the limit of the infinitely many players, of course, already. And that's the thing I'm going to speak about. So the infinitely many, but they are distributed among the three states. And you see this equation, in fact, can be seen from two points of view. First of all, you can write the explicit Markov model, yeah, with this lambda exponential time, each pair interact, they jump, and depending on the mean field. Or you can just write this equation, and that's how this is usually done in economics literature, yeah? We just write this equation, yeah, without any sort of Markov preparation, yeah? And see that this is, in fact, obvious, yeah? What is here obvious, yeah? So this is the number of reserved, yeah? How they can be decreased, yeah? They can be decreased with the rate proportional to the recovery and to their number, okay? How they can be increased, yeah? They can be increased by corrupted guys who wanted to make your, who wanted to make you honest, and vice versa. So each term here, yeah? This term is your decision, yeah? So every term here, yeah, has really explicit meaning, which you can see directly. Yeah? But it can be shown and can be proved rigorously. Yeah? Struct Markov model, limit of the generator, and we'll get the thing. Yeah? So yes, this is this Markov approximation. You see the formulas again become a bit lengthy, but again, you can see the generator, actually, of the jump Markov process. It tells you what can happen, yeah? You can increase the number of reserved by one, and at the same point, the number of corrupt decreases by one. So corrupted becomes punished and reserved. And here's the same. Reserved decreases, but he is promoted, yeah, to the initial, yeah? So this every, again, every terms here, this has clear meaning of the jump type process. And in the limit, you will get this equation which was written above. Okay, so now again, here it is explained how this limit can be obtained somehow formally. Yeah? You write the generator, you assume that your function is smooth, then you can expand it via Taylor series, and therefore your generator actually converges to the first order partial differential operator. First order partial differential operator describes a deterministic Markov process. Yeah? And that's what we get, this deterministic evolution which was written, this precisely this deterministic process. Okay, but I have written this Markov approximation specifically to introduce the second part of the story, this Hamilton-Jacobi. Yeah? As usual now, mean field game, we have this evolution, and then we have the Hamilton-Jacobi, which describes your individual preferences. And this is our Hamilton-Jacobi equation coming from the, again, Markov process in for individual, yeah? Assuming we have this background axis, yeah, distribution given, yeah? Then I'm going to optimize according to this process. I'm going to optimize. I solve my Hamilton-Jacobi equation. This describes me how many elements will be there and there. This should coincide with the so this is now the Hamilton-Jacobi equation. Again, a bit lengthy, yeah, but you see this is the evolution of your capital, yeah? It includes a per unit of time payment for the corresponding state which you are reserved, honest, yeah? So these are the changes, yeah? Yeah, you see the whole structure of Hamilton-Jacobi equation, yeah? Payment plus jumps according to the model. So these are payments, these are jumps according to the model. And what you are interested in, so you are interested in this consistency, of course. And this, I suppose, should be the simplest slide for everybody. This is kind of standard thing, yeah? We have this starting control, yeah? From this control, we can then find the dynamics, yeah? If we know what everyone is doing, we can find how many doing what, then we find the dynamics. By this dynamics, we then construct this individual control, already knowing, yeah, this background, and then we have to have the thing equal. So this is the usual consistency equation written for this discrete setting. Okay, and now I'm talking about stationary problem. Yeah, this time dependent, of course, is still very complicated. Okay, and we're interested in the stationary. Everything becomes stationary. So the our control parameters are stationary. So once I want something, I want this. Yeah. So this is really concerned some stationary regimes. Yeah. And then derivative with respect to time disappears. Okay, so Hamilton-Jacobi also becomes stationary. And there are two versions. Possibly you remember those who are dealing with this stationary problem. There are two ways of doing stationary. One is introducing discounting, yeah? And another is introducing payment per unit of time. So this is this payment per unit of time, this mu. So this is written in terms of average payment, and you can also write it in terms of discounting. And in fact, discounting is simpler to deal with for various reasons. Yeah? Okay, and therefore you have this now the equation for the distribution also becomes now just stationary, you see? So everything is stationary, and in fact you have here kind of six equation, but they are all Hamilton-Jacobi plus this, but they are now algebraic. Yeah? Therefore, in principle, this thing is easy to do numerically. Yeah? And this, well, in some sense easy, will be preserved to four state and two and so on, yeah? But once you get a bit more number, yeah, then really to see behind this numeric what's going on is rather difficult. Okay, you can do numerics, yeah, but what does it tell us, yeah? What are the features there? So in order to see what's really going on, yeah, we introduce this, well, beyond three-state model where everything is solvable, we start to introducing these asymptotic regimes, yeah, to see really approximately profiles, so to say. What can we expect under different assumptions? Okay, so that's the theorem which I mentioned, and I'm not writing you this explicit solution because you will not, you know, see anything from these numbers, but they are explicit. And that's the beautiful point about it, that we have really, as I mentioned, phase transition as in van der Waals. Yeah, we have either one or three, and we directly see how this comes from one to another. So you really see the critical point, yeah? And you see what are the parameters which are involving, yeah? So you see there are several parameters, and as I mentioned, of course, this, they are difficult to really to get, yeah? What is the probability of the social norm, yeah? So this kind of things which are hidden there, which is a difficult point. But at least what we can say, what combination of this parameter really plays a role. So all this phase transition depends on one combination with the social, infection, yeah, probability. They all form one number. And once this number goes beyond some level, then we get three. When it goes below some level, we have one. Yeah? So at least we know approximately on which combination of the thing, yeah, the whole story depends. So as I say, here three state, everything is explicit. Explicit for the stationary thing, yeah? Not for time dependent. But for time dependent, these turnpikes, about which I plan to say, but possibly I will not have time. But anyway, I mentioned it already, yeah? And well, there are papers on this. I have several papers and they're all on archive. So I mean, I passed you the main ideas and in detail can be looked at. Okay, so now, botnet defense second model, which I here drawn here, yeah? So we have now four states, yeah? Defended, infected, defended, susceptible. What is you? Unprotected, yeah, unprotected. Yeah, yeah, it is written, of course, yeah. So you see there are pairs, DU and SI, yeah? Susceptible, infected, defended, undefected, yeah? And now again, the parameters, now we have four numbers describing user state, yeah? Number, and again, we have divided by the normalizing by the total number to get frequencies. Okay, so again, we have two parameters, yeah? So the movement, you see there is this, the movement of your decision goes only here horizontally. Yeah? This distribution between infected and not infected is not your under your control. Yeah? And that's always in this picture. Yeah? So one thing is under the, one direction is under the control of the herder or principal, yeah? Or benevolent dictator. Yeah? And another parameter is under your control. Your level of defense, your level of involvement in corruption, your level of terrorism attack, yeah? So the same here. So this, and this U is, again, just, are you happy with your state? Or you'd like to change it to whatever other, yeah? Very simple. So control is, again, not some interval, yeah? It's really finite number of points. And now we have this binary interaction, yeah? That's what makes this story already complicated, yeah? So this is propagation of infection via the network, yeah? So this is something which already, so you see there is third level, there's one level dictator, yeah? He makes some efforts to infect your computer, yeah? He makes some efforts to find corrupted behavior. There is your decision, second level, mean field type sort of, yeah? I decide to change my state, or I do not decide to change my state. And there is a third level, this is kind of evolutionary interaction, binary, which is already not under control, neither of your decision, nor of this herder, yeah? This is what can be interpreted in social norms in the social thing, or just the propagation of infection between the computers. And they, of course, depend on whether you are defended or not. But still, you can be affected. And there are different rates with which the computer can be infected, yeah, depending on the level of your control, of your defense. Okay, so these are kinetic equations. You see, they are becoming more complicated, yeah? And of course, it's very difficult just looking at them and, you know, see. But if you just pay attention to one particular sort of here term, you will see where it comes from, yeah? So, yeah, if you were not infected, then there is a way to become infected. It can comes either from binary interaction or it comes from the herder. Okay, you are defended or not defended. You can change this by your decision, yeah? And the decision depends on this rate, lambda, yeah? This is the parameter of the exponential distribution, which defines how quick you can make your changes, okay? So again, we have individual Markov chain. You see, again, complicated. Let me not put much time on it. There is payment, which you pay when you are defended and infected. So you have to pay for being defended, and you have cost for being infected, yeah? So this is total cost. And you can write Hamilton-Jacobi equation, and again, the same mean field stuff. And so this is time dependent. Now it makes all time independent, stationary, with discounting or with control per point. Lengthy equation, again. Now mixing this with the evolution of the distributions, we have this much more complicated. You see now this 4 plus 4 is 8 equations. Again, let me stress, they are simple in the sense of 8 algebraic equations. Again, you can do numerics here, yeah? But it's very difficult to see what's going on. So in order to see what's going on, here really we'll start to employ our first sort of gun, yeah? You can think about this asymptotic as some weapons, you know? So which we introduce more and more sophisticated weapons, yeah? So it's the first weapon, fast execution, lambda to infinity. When lambda to infinity, then several terms, these nasty terms with mean max, they disappear. Because when lambda to infinity, then this should be zero, otherwise, yeah? So when lambda to infinity, the max mean disappears, yeah? And the story becomes much more simple. And for this four-state model, with this lambda to infinity limit, we again solve everything, yeah? We can find now, well, I have written here this concentration, solution. Let me pass it, yeah? But this is the main result, yeah? Again, you can, now with three solutions, you have four solutions, fully classified, you see? And there are rather lengthy calculations, yeah? But very clear formulas, yeah? So if you look at this final formula, they are really not so complicated as the calculation which leading to them. Explicit solution, stationary. And then you see again all this bifurcation. Okay, now more complicated than van der Waals because the switching between actually four regimes, yeah? But you again have some parameter and you see how it moves this parameter, yeah? My student, Stamatis, he writes, draws very nice pictures. And you can see how this parameter moves and there are some night light moves around, red to green, you see it very nicely and completely, yeah? How this thing changes when this one parameter moves between all these possibilities. Okay, so I have, I suppose, 3 minutes left, yeah? Well, 3 minutes left, then you see I touched you this two part. In fact, I plan to speak mostly about this because it's somehow the most developed model, yeah? But, well, anyway, you can see already what's going on, yeah? So when the equations for this model becomes the same, but now it will be not 8, it will be 4D equations, yeah? Again, numerics already basically senseless, even though it is possible, yeah? So lambda to infinity asymptotics is not enough. We take another gun, yeah? Now, we take small d asymptotics, yeah? And we have weak interaction asymptotic. By the way, interaction previously was this beta, yeah? This binary interaction. So we take this beta to zero, and we're discounting delta to zero. And under this assumption, you can basically, again, explicitly, yeah, describe the solution of the stationary problem. And both for this setting and even for this more developed setting, yeah? So that's concerning stationary. And then finally, I just again make this final comment about the Turnpike, yeah? That afterwards, in fact, you can prove that there is a class of solutions of already non-stationary problem for which these stationary are like the Turnpikes. So almost all the time, if you start with a distribution which is not too far away from the solution of the stationary problem, yeah, then you still remain nearby, yeah? Mostly all the time. In the same with the cost. You take your final cost, which is in certain region of attraction, explicitly described, yeah? In certain region of attraction of a stationary problem, you have this Turnpike property also for the costs. Okay, so you have the class of time-dependent solution. Now, in final comments, here I talked all about time to infinity, number of players infinity. But there are results, we have the results that this infinite number of players solution approximate, which is epsilon, yeah, Nash for finite number. So all these results, they give you, again, concrete estimation of the epsilon Nash equilibrium for a finite state game with, again, more or less explicit this epsilon epsilon Nash. This epsilon is usually one over number of the players, 1 over n in this finite dimensional setting. Okay, and I suppose I'll stop here. Thank you.